Ever wondered why some applications stand out, while others fall flat on their face? The answer lies in the quality of the software. It's like the backbone of any application, determining whether it thrives or withers away. High-quality software can significantly increase productivity, offer a superior user experience, and improve a business's reputation. But how do we define high quality? That's where the International Organization for Standardization, or ISO, and the International Electrotechnical Commission, or IEC, come in. They've established a norm, the ISO IEC 25010, which outlines a set of characteristics that determine software quality. These characteristics act as a roadmap, guiding developers and quality analysts to create software that meets the highest standards. In today's world, software quality is not just an option, it's a necessity. It's the difference between an app that's a joy to use and one that's a constant source of frustration. So let's delve deeper into what makes software truly high quality. Let's dive into the heart of software quality, the ISO IEC 25010 norm. Now, if you're wondering what this norm is, think of it as a criterion, a benchmark, that helps us gauge the quality of a software product. It's an international standard, followed by industries across the globe. And it's your guiding star when you're navigating the vast cosmos of software quality. This norm is like a compass, pointing out 8 different directions, or rather, characteristics, that define software quality. Picture these 8 characteristics as a team, each bringing its unique strength to the table, working together to create a high-quality software product. First up, we have functional suitability. This is all about how well a software performs its intended functions. Next, there's reliability. This characteristic measures how dependable a software product is and how well it can maintain its performance under specified conditions. Then we have usability, which refers to how user-friendly and easy to understand the software is. Following this, we have efficiency, which is all about the software's capability to provide appropriate performance relative to the amount of resources used. Next in line is maintainability. This characteristic is all about how easy it is to identify and fix issues in the software. Then we have portability, which is the software's ability to be transferred from one environment to another. Our 7th characteristic, compatibility, measures how well the software can coexist with other systems, while our final characteristic, security, is all about protecting information and data from unauthorized access. So there you have it, the 8 characteristics defined by the ISO IEC 25010 norm. Each one is a vital piece of the puzzle, and together they give us a comprehensive view of what software quality really means. Remember, this isn't just about ticking boxes or meeting a quota. It's about understanding what each characteristic brings to the table and how they collectively contribute to the overall quality of a software product. Understanding this norm is the first step towards creating high-quality software. Let's talk about the first characteristic, functional suitability. Now, what exactly is functional suitability? In simple terms, it refers to the degree to which a software product provides functions that meet both stated and implied needs when used under specified conditions. It might sound a bit technical, but think of it as the software's ability to do what it's designed to do, effectively and efficiently. Functional suitability is not just about the software doing its job, but doing it well and providing value to the user. It's about ensuring that the software is not just functional, but suitable for the task at hand. Let's break it down further into its sub-characteristics: functional completeness, functional correctness, and functional appropriateness. Functional completeness is about the software providing all the necessary functions. It's like buying a car. You expect it to have all the necessary parts: wheels, engine, seats. Similarly, a software should have all the necessary functions to perform its task. Next, we have functional correctness. This is about the software performing its functions correctly. Going back to our car analogy, it's not enough for the car to just have an engine. The engine needs to work properly. Similarly, the functions of a software need to work as intended. Lastly, there's functional appropriateness. This is about the software providing functions that are appropriate for the task. If you're buying a car for family use, you'd want it to have enough seats, not just a powerful engine. Similarly, a software should provide functions that are relevant and useful to the user's needs. Taken together, these sub-characteristics ensure that the software is not just functional, but also suitable for the task at hand. They make sure that the software is complete, correct, and appropriate. In conclusion, Functional suitability is all about the software doing what it's supposed to do, effectively and efficiently. It's about ensuring that the software provides value to the user and meets their needs and expectations. Functional suitability ensures that the software does what it's supposed to do, no more, no less. Next up, reliability. Reliability in the context of software quality is the extent to which a system, product, or component performs its specified functions under specified conditions over a specified period. In other words, it's a measure of how consistently a software performs its intended function without succumbing to failure. Imagine you're driving a car. You'd want your brakes to work every single time you press the pedal, right? That's reliability in practice. It's the same with software. Whether you're sending an email, processing a payment, or even playing a game, you expect the software to function as intended every time you use it. Now, reliability has four sub-characteristics: maturity, availability, fault tolerance, and recoverability. Let's break these down. First up is maturity. It's not about the age of the software, but how stable it is. A mature software has been tested thoroughly and has had most of its bugs ironed out. It's been through the ringer and has come out on the other side stronger and more reliable. Next, we have availability. This is pretty straightforward. It's about how often the software is up and running, ready to perform its function. A high availability software is one that's always there when you need it. Thirdly, we have fault tolerance. This is the software's ability to continue functioning even when things go wrong. It's like a tightrope walker who keeps their balance even when the wind blows. Lastly, we have recoverability. This refers to the software's ability to recover from a failure and regain its functionality. It's like a boxer who gets knocked down but gets back up and keeps fighting. In a nutshell, reliability is about the software's ability to deliver consistent performance, regardless of the circumstances. It's about ensuring that users can trust the software to function as expected every single time. Reliability is all about consistency and performance. Now, let's turn our attention to usability. Usability, in the simplest of terms, measures how user-friendly and intuitive a software product is. It's the degree to which a product or system can be used by specified users to achieve specified goals with effectiveness, efficiency, and satisfaction in a specified context of use. Let's break that down a bit. Usability isn't just about whether a user can perform a task with the software, it's also about how effectively they can do it, how efficiently they can achieve their goals, and how satisfied they are with their experience. It's a multifaceted characteristic that takes into account the whole user experience. Now, usability itself is composed of several sub-characteristics, each playing a crucial role. First up, we have understandability. This is about how easily users can understand the software's functions and how to use them. If the user is constantly scratching their head, trying to decipher what to do next, then we've got an understandability issue. Next up is learnability. This measures how easily a new user can learn to use the software. A steep learning curve can be a major deterrent for many users. Then we have operability. This is all about how much control the user has over the software. Can they easily navigate and control its functions, or are they left feeling frustrated and out of control? We also consider attractiveness. While it might sound superficial, the look and feel of a software product can greatly impact a user's satisfaction. An attractive, well-designed user interface can make the software more enjoyable to use. Last, but certainly not least, we have user interface aesthetics. This goes beyond just attractiveness. It's about creating a visually pleasing and balanced interface that enhances the user's experience. All these sub-characteristics work together to create a usable software product. They ensure that the product doesn't just function, but it's also user-friendly and intuitive. It's about creating a software product that users not only need to use, but want to use. Usability ensures that the software is user-friendly and intuitive. Time to focus on efficiency. When we talk about efficiency in the context of software quality, we're looking at the performance of a system relative to the amount of resources used under stated conditions. This is a crucial aspect of the ISO, IEC, 25010 norm that directly impacts user satisfaction and overall system performance. Let's dive deeper into what efficiency means. Imagine a software that can perform tasks quickly, but it drains your device's battery or uses up all your system's memory. That software, while fast, wouldn't be considered efficient. An efficient software is one that not only performs tasks quickly, but also uses resources wisely. In the realm of software quality, efficiency is further broken down into two sub-characteristics: Time behavior and resource utilization. Let's unpack these. Time behavior refers to the response and processing times and throughput rates of a software product. It's about how quickly a system can perform a function or process a request. This aspect is crucial in today's fast-paced world where every second counts. Users typically don't want to wait around for a software to respond. They want quick, instant results. On the other hand, resource utilization is all about how well a software uses resources like memory, CPU, and power. An efficient software product is one that maximizes its performance while minimizing the amount of resources it uses. It's about doing more with less. This not only ensures better system performance, but also contributes to the longevity of the hardware. In a nutshell, efficiency is about balance. It is about striking the right balance between speed and resource consumption. A software product that is efficient is one that can perform tasks quickly, but not at the cost of draining resources. So, the next time you're evaluating software, remember to consider its efficiency. Look at how quickly it performs tasks and how well it uses resources. Remember, an efficient software product is one that does more with less, and that's what makes it stand out. Efficiency ensures that the software makes the best use of resources. We're down to the last three characteristics. So, let's dive right in. First, we have maintainability. Imagine you've built a beautiful sandcastle, but the tide is coming in. You need to make some quick changes to prevent it from washing away. The ease with which you can make these alterations is the essence of maintainability. In software terms, it's the degree to which a product can be modified to correct faults, improve performance or other attributes, or adapt to a changing environment. A maintainable system enables us to respond swiftly and efficiently to user needs, bugs, or evolving technological landscapes. Next up is portability. Think of this as your suitcase's ability to fit into various overhead compartments on different airlines. In software, portability is the ease with which the system can be transferred from one hardware or software environment to another. This could be moving from an old server to a new one, or from one operating system to another. The more portable a system is, the more flexible and adaptable it becomes. It's like having a universal power adapter in a world full of different electrical outlets. Finally, let's talk about security. We all know the importance of feeling safe and secure in our homes. Similarly, software needs to protect data and maintain functionality as intended. Security in the software context is the degree to which a product or system protects information and data, so that persons or other products or systems have the degree of data access appropriate to their types and levels of authorization. It's like a combination lock on a safe, keeping your valuables secure from unauthorized access. To sum it all up, maintainability allows us to keep our software up to date and in tune with user needs and technological changes. Portability gives our software the flexibility to adapt to different environments. And security ensures our software is a safe and trusted platform for users to interact with. Each of these characteristics plays a crucial role in determining the quality of software. So, what does all this mean to you? Well, let's dive into the practical implications of the ISO IEC 25010 norm. Imagine you're a software developer or a quality analyst. You're not just creating code or testing it, you're crafting experiences, solving problems, and meeting user needs. And this is where the ISO IEC 25010 norm comes into play. By understanding and applying these characteristics, we're not just talking about abstract concepts or technical jargon, we're discussing the essence of what makes software good. We're talking about functional suitability, reliability, usability, efficiency, and the other characteristics we've explored. Think about functional suitability. It's all about ensuring the software does what it's supposed to do. It's about creating something that users can rely on, that meets their needs, and that solves their problems. Consider reliability. It's not just about avoiding crashes, bugs, or errors. It's about building trust with users, ensuring that they can count on the software when they need it most. Reflect on usability. It's not just about making software easy to use. It's about creating an enjoyable, intuitive, and satisfying experience for users. It's about making people's lives easier, not harder. Ponder over efficiency. It's not just about making software run faster or use less resources. It's about respecting users' time and making the most out of their hardware. And the other characteristics? They're just as important. They're about security, compatibility, maintainability, and portability. They're about creating software that's safe, that works well with other systems, that's easy to update and improve, and that can be used on different devices or platforms. In short, understanding and applying the ISO, IEC 25010 norm is not just about ticking boxes or following rules. It's about creating software that truly stands out. It's about making a difference in people's lives. And that, my friends, is what software development and quality analysis are all about. Understanding and applying the ISO, IEC 25010 norm is the key to creating software that truly stands out.